going to start the show.
With you.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Well, let's give it.
Let's give this a go.
What we're going to do is the medley.
The medley first.
You're going to start with the medley, and then you go from the medley to Piece of Heaven, and let's see how that sounds. So let's go through this and see.
What kind of
tea
is that?
Throat tea.
Welcome, Donnie, on stage. Come on.
When I think of you, I just think of like music and lights, just the illusion,
flashlight.
That's what I think.
See, I'm into the In and Out of Love, some Body Talk.
In and Out of Love as well. gosh, man, you got too much tune.
Yeah, so Body Talk and stuff like that, because you know they were like real club, you know, real, because it came from the street. People were saying, oh, you know, we.
That's so that is those tunes. It's those tunes. It's those tunes made me want to do it.
Early clubs is pure roots and pure club. Nowadays everything is in like a commercial genre where they put everything in like little brackets.
Right.
In those days, none of it was created. Right. It was just purely
fresh.
It was purely what we made. Yeah. There was no, we didn't follow anyone. We had to do our own thing.
That's what I liked about it. Yeah,
do our own thing. And that's classic. It. Shit. So I showed a little bit more leg, and that was about it.
Lee's music, right, if people really want to know, right, you know, Lee's music changed music across the world during the period of time that imaginations were making. I went to Egypt and everything was like, dum, 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 dum. I go to America, dum, 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 dum. I go to France, I'm with him the night in France, the Champs-Élysées, they cut off the road. Dun, 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 dun. Everywhere in the world, there wasn't anywhere that I went to that his music didn't touch.
But we have this situation in the UK where we put down everything. You know, we bring them all up and then we put them down. While in America, if you are Gladys Knight or someone that's been gone for 3,000 years, they elevate you, they escalate you, they adore you, you're on a real level. And I'm proud of, you know, the work everyone has done. But right out front, we have a limited period of time. Very limited when it comes to artists.
I just believe that there's something in place in this country whereby they find it really, really difficult to accept the fact that they've pushed the multicultural perspective on us, but they're not truly willing to embrace that perspective. Yeah. And that's my problem.
We talk about the industry after Body Talk and stuff. We were talking about, he said, look, I came to see your show. I said, I came to see you because he was doing backgrounds with Lynx, I remember. Yeah. So we would tear everything to bits, but it was real good. It was real, and we got on really well.
With the Jerry Curl,
And we talk about the industry. And as the years went on, it was like every once a year we'd meet up and have this one long conversation. And it survived. I mean, we're talking about 30 odd years later.
Thank you very much.
We all have so much to offer, especially to younger artists as well. You know, we're now having to educate people because there's so much in the industry that people don't know. We are in a very reality-driven time where people think, oh, that's the way to do it. That's the way, you know, they didn't graft. You know, they weren't doing the gigs that we did before. We had to lift up the Leslie on the stage and set up your own microphone and set up your own reverb machines, which I had to do. People think I just went on there to... I can't even do it, man. There was a lot of groundwork in what we did initially, and we were part of this whole unique soul scene that was happening in the UK. We were not into disco, we were into the funk and nothing but the funk.
Thank you!
Ladies and gentlemen, we are just collecting. Thank you very much for having us tonight.
That was it. That was happening in the late 70s. We were part of this whole club scene. What the media interpreted and what was then sent out was always very, very different. And I think that's what we have, knowledge and education. And that is something that we can give back to the next generation. And with the British Collective, that can keep this whole thing going. And so the next legacy of people can go on. You know, everyone has contributed something so mega.
I came from the reggae side, started in roots reggae from school. Reggae at the time in the 70s was really, really big, bigger than soul, because you had Soul Edge, you had Rebels, you had Rasses. And for me, I was in all of them. I was in the punk, I had my mates, I played in the punk bands at school and at the youth clubs. I'd go and rehearse with these guys. I'd already made records at 13, rehearsing with Junior's band, which my brother Corner was in, a band called Atlantis, that's right. And my approach in music has always been from as Junior said, all of the influences, what I got from here, the rock, the punk, I've always fused that in my music. And it happened in America, but for some reason here, it doesn't get acknowledged when it's done by our kind. So what you do, you start traveling and you realize, boy, people really like this music. And you get to realize that your music is not accepted in the place where you make the music. And it's a kind of fight, and I think for me anyway, I can say what that's done for me, it's made me even more determined in music, and I fuse my music, I've worked with so many different people. It's made me really appreciate my music, and as opposed to being knocked down all the time. I work all over the world, and you know, reggae for me, the biggest music, all the majors are signing it again, they're looking for the big reggae act. They do this all the time. They use the bass line, the heavy bass line drums. America, since then, America's music has always been more heavier bass. It was never that way inclined. So the reggae music, you know, is a very pinnacle part of this whole conversation, because as Junior said, blues, you know the blues. You guys know the blues, but we're a bit older, so we lived the blues. I was in blues at 12. I was very young when I started in this game. I was very lucky and fortunate. And I think on this album, you know, Donnie's done most of the production on it.
Great production.
And I think what you're going to hear on 1, 2, 3, and 4, you'll hear that history come from the music, because we've got so much more to bring. Omar's music style is very, you know, Omar's dad is the man who used to inspire me when he was in his reggae band. So the music that Omar does has that flavour with the jazz, with all the other influences.
Holy shit.
It's you then.
Thank Donnie. Thank
Donnie. Yeah, thanks Donnie. Well, I find that our music's very unique to us anyway, because it's the heritage of what we have. I mean, this is where they made jungle. They made grime and two-step and all them things there. That's that could only come from me.
Sip a glass of cold champagne wine. The rug that we lie on feels divine.
And I say it's a mixture of lively up yourself. and knees up Mother Brown. Yeah, yeah, do you know what I mean? Yeah, that's the only one place it is.
I grew up listening to all you lot, really, basically.
Really, yeah.
All of these guys made me want to do it. All of these guys.
You know, I remember listening to Pirate Station up in West London, and always used to be Rick Clark on the advert. So he's going to be here, he's going to be there. And I was like, well, that's where I want to be doing it.
You know what I mean? When I first heard you, I thought you were Rick Clark. Seriously, I thought, hold on a minute.
Rick is a part of this project as well. And Rick is one of the first, I'd say, if you want to say like, reggae man turned soul. He was the first one to bridge that. And he was signed to a major, and they again they kind of messed it up with Rick.
Can't have, tell me what, there's nothing like this. Well, baby, speed up, there's nothing like this. No one could ever have what we have.
There's nothing like this.
The most important thing, right, with the project wasn't that Omar had to sing here and Lee had to sing there or so-and-so had to do this or whatever else. The project pretty much been in coming together has been, what's your vibe to this? What's your vibe to this? And then working with that vibe, editing, talking, this one should only...
Some songs only have two people.
Only two people on, or it has maybe three other people singing lead, right? And some of us are doing seven. Backgrounds, so seven people as we got on one singing lead. But all of this, when you've been able to put it together and it all seems to flow, and you realised, for me, what I realised was the common thread through all of us was what you said, was reggae. I heard it in everybody's voice. No matter how they tried to twist it, there was some kind of yard in there. I'm serious! Involved in this, it's been an education musically. When we started, Donnie and I sat down and Donnie said, boy, what should we do? You know, boy, should I come up with this right time, that, and I looked at everybody and I'm like, hey, what happened? And I worked for 20 odd years and I looked for somebody as the co-writer. I thought, what?
What
go on?
That's what we're doing.
We've been doing it for a long time. We are masters at what we do. Not just that it's authentic, we are masters at it. We've not been doing this for 4 years, 5 years. We've been doing it for 20 odd years. Most of us 30. So when you walk on that stage, you know exactly what you're doing. You want that audience. You've been doing this for 30 years. You're a master at it. For me, this project is, for me personally, it's the most exciting thing I've been involved in. Right? You know, just because of the fact that like what we're trying to achieve, like, is groundbreaking in this country. It's not been done before. We've all been blessed to be able to have carved out a career for ourselves and still be able to earn and still be able to live in the mindset that you want to live in, right? Most people are so fortunate, and we've been blessed.
Blessed, you know, give thanks.
Yeah, right, you know, you give thanks and that. Friends, I wanna take it all, who I got to ask.
I mean, Dom and Masway, he does it.
I think that's the beauty of the whole thing, though. It's the fact that everybody is individualistic, right? So what you're getting is a collective force of something very magnetic. You have five individuals, not five men being in groups all the way along, but it's five individuals. Man.
I'm just happy to be it. To me, it means the first time it's history, and we're creating history again, and it's solidarity within that, because we are friends. So it's about making a change.
I think it speaks for itself. It's in the music. It's there, and I think people are going to embrace it. I think they are embracing it. It's something they've been asking for a long time, and I think we're giving a fresh statement. And it's something that's not just confined to just the UK. It's universal. It's international, and that's what it's all about. It's taking it way across the ocean. And I think when it busts in the States and it busts in Japan, you know, busts everybody in their face. It will come back, and that's what I like about it. You know, I think that. It's a natural feeling, you know. I think if you feel it, you go with it. That's how it has to be. It's got to be organic. And I think that the British Collective, it's going to be a universal brand.
All right, like Junior said, five people at the top of their game.
Well, I think New Edition could sleep safely in their beds.
There's other people that we, you know, yeah, Carl, yeah, Rick, Sean Scoffrey, you know what I mean? So this is all part of the beginnings of that. Yeah. So it's nice to be on, you know, getting in on the ground level.
Lyndon
David Hall as well. Yeah, yeah. LDH, man, you know what I mean? Man. So rest in peace.
Spiritual, man. Spiritual.
That's what it is. I think when we break this whole thing down, that's exactly what it is. We started from spiritual.
Yes.
And that's what we're doing. Everything from the lyrical content to this album to the way that it feels, it's spiritual. And to me, I feel that like what we've done coming together is incredible to me. It shows. Because when you say everybody's name to people, I'm smiling, but when you say everybody's name to people, they're being like in shock. You mean to tell me, oh, golly, man, what's that? Instead, so for me, it was like, you know, that whole thing of 30 years down the line, right? And here we are creating a music form, right? That's ours, completely ours. It's not infested, it's not manifested. It's just completely what we do. And if given to the right people in this country and around the world, it will be massive. Because, as you both have said, it's authentic.
Summer day,
tell them call.
Girl, you take my stress away.
Woo.
Like it ain't a thing.
You don't have to try.
Oh,
no.
Oh.
Like you know just what I need. You got a shoulder I can lean.
I'm talking about the crashing thing. Otherwise, I will pose. And you don't want me to be.
You know what I think you would.
Isn't that
bad? There are times when you need to do it. Otherwise, they put real shit out there.
Well, we know your song. I mean, your song.
Hey, we find fruit.
Where's food come from?
I'm a fool. Oh. Yeah, girl.
I threw that the wrong way.
Where you find from?
Said a small boy once asked people like,
all right, Barry.